Start the recording. So under this particular fifth unit, that is branch and bound, so far we have discussed two types of approach to solve the 0x1 knapsack problem. The first one is nothing but the FIFO branch and bound, whereas the second one is nothing but the LC branch and bound. FIFO stands for first in, first out branch and bound, whereas LC stands for least cost branch and bound. Okay, so these two important types of problem solving techniques which we have discussed under the branch and bound, and that too we have solved 0x1 knapsack problem using these two important methods. Okay, so today we are going to start with the next very important topic, that is traveling salesperson problem. As far as the end semester examination is concerned, total 18 marks weightage will be given to this particular unit, that is branch and bound. And if you refer the previous year question papers, most of the times the 18 marks question itself is asked on traveling salesperson problem using branch and bound. Okay, so you can refer the previous year question papers, you will find the single question, that is traveling salesperson problem using branch and bound, is asked for 18 marks. So accordingly you can imagine the weightage of this particular point or this particular topic. So let me share the screen with you so that I can start the important topic of today's lecture, that is traveling salesperson problem using branch and bound. Okay, so for this we have to see one problem and we have to solve this particular problem, that is 0x1 knapsack problem using branch and bound. You can write the problem statement. You can write the problem statement. Solve the following TSP, that is traveling salesperson problem. Solve the following traveling salesperson problem using branch and bound technique. So let me share, let me start the camera. A very important point for today's lecture. Dear student, you can acknowledge me whether it is visible to you, whether the board is visible to you, dear student. Yes, whether the board is visible to you. Okay, fine, make sure that it is clearly visible. Fine, so I hope you might have written the problem statement. Solve the following traveling salesperson problem using branch and bound technique. Okay, and dear student, you are already aware with this particular problem, that is traveling salesperson problem. You have already solved the traveling salesperson problem using dynamic programming. So what happens in problem statement? In problem statement you'll be given with the graph. In problem statement you'll be given with one graph, and you have to find the solution of this particular traveling salesperson problem. There are various approaches. One is dynamic programming, and second right now we are going to discuss is nothing but the branch and bound. Fine, so let us discuss the problem statement. Here you'll be having node 1. Okay. This is vertex 2 and this is vertex 3. Okay. So one is connected to 2 with weight 4. 2 is connected to 1 with weight 3. One is connected to 3 with weight 2. 3 is connected to 1 with weight 1. 2 is connected to 3 with weight 4. And 3 is connected to 2 with weight 8. I hope all of you have written the problem statement. I hope all of you have written the problem statement, means the all of you have drawn the diagram. This is node 1, node 2, and this is node 3. Okay. Now, how to solve this particular problem? How to solve this particular problem using branch and bound? So, dear student, first of all, we have to represent this graph in the form of adjacency matrix. We have to represent this graph in the form of adjacency matrix. So let us first of all represent this graph in the form of adjacency matrix. So how I can represent this graph in the form of adjacency matrix? So that I can represent, we'll be calling it as A. A is equals to, A is the adjacency matrix, and 1 to 1. 1 to 1. Now what is the distance of 1 to 1? Yes, dear student, you can type in chat box 1 to 1 distance. 1 to 1 distance, you can type in chat box. I hope I'm clear and louder. Okay, what is the distance of 1 to 1? Let me see how many of you are giving the correct answer. 0. Okay, fine. Anybody else? Anybody else? 0 is not the correct answer. Dear student, 0 is not the correct answer. In this case, 0 is not the correct answer. Infinity. Yes, correct. Absolutely fine. Yes, Rishikesh, here. In this particular case, we have to consider infinity. Okay. Am I audible, dear student? Hello. Yes, dear student. Am I audible? Is there any connectivity issue? I'm clearly audible. Okay, fine. So infinity is the correct answer. 1 to 1 is nothing but the infinity. Fine. Then 1 to 2. What is 1 to 2, dear student? Let me ask for first few cases. Later on, I'll write down. What is 1 to 2? 1 to 2 distance. 1 to 2 is 4. Absolutely correct. That is 4. 1 to 3 is nothing but 2. Okay. Then 2 to 1 is nothing but the 2 to 1 is 3. Then 2 to 2 is infinity. 2 to 3 is nothing but the 4. Again here it is 4. Then 3 to 1 is nothing but 3 to 1 is nothing but 1. 3 to 2 is nothing but 8. And 3 to 3 is nothing but the infinity. So, dear student, whether it is correct or any mistake or any changes, accordingly you can tell me whether it is correct. Whatever we have written, that is the first step. Whatever we have written is the first step. Okay, we'll go slowly so that you will understand the entire problem, because here only values are different. Problem is one and same. Okay. We have to solve the traveling salesperson problem using branch and bound. So only values are different. Okay. So accordingly, you need to understand the steps. Here, there are a few important steps which we need to understand. Okay. Once you'll be able to understand all those steps, then it is very easy to solve this particular problem. problem. Okay, so this is the first step. Now what we have to do, dear student, here in branch and bound, you know very well, when we are finding the solution, we have to represent the solution in the form of state space tree. So whenever we are representing the solution in the form of state space tree, we have to find the lower bound. We have to find the lower bound, okay, with respect to different nodes. So here we have to find out the lower bound with respect to root node. So what will be the root node, or how many nodes will be there in the given state space tree? Forget about that. First of all, concentrate on how to find the lower bound value. Okay, so obviously here, first of all, we are going to start, we are going to find the lower bound value with respect to node, root node. So what is the lower bound value of root node that we have to find? So how to find the lower bound value of root node? So to find the lower bound value of root node, what we have to do, we have to find the minimum here. Right now, whatever the matrix is there in front of you, how many rows are there? Dear student, how many rows are there in this matrix? How many rows are there in this matrix? How many rows are there? Got my question? How many rows are there in this matrix? How many rows are there? Absolutely correct. So we have to find out what is the minimum value in this row, first row, second row, and third row. What is the minimum value of first row, second row, and third row? Your answer is correct. There are three rows. So what is the minimum value in the first row? Come on. What is the minimum value in the first row? What is the minimum value in the first row? In Marathi, first row chi minimum value kaya hai? 2. Absolutely correct. Here minimum value is 2. What is the minimum value of second row? Minimum value of second row is 3. And what is the minimum value of third row? Minimum value of third row is nothing but 1. Okay, these are the respective minimum values of the respective rows. Now what we have to do, dear student, we have to just subtract. We have to subtract those minimum values from the respective rows. We have to subtract this minimum value from the respective rows. Now all of you know very well how we can perform addition and subtraction operation on the matrix. Okay, so this 2 we have to subtract from the first row, this 3 we have to subtract from the second row, and this 1 we have to subtract from the third row. So let us subtract. After subtracting, we'll be getting new matrix. After subtracting these values, we'll be getting new matrix, and that new matrix value is there any change in the infinity? Infinity minus 2, what is the value? It is obviously infinity. But 4 minus 2 is 2, whereas 2 minus 2 is 0. Fine. 3 minus 3 is 0. Infinity minus 3 is infinity. 4 minus 3 is 1. 1 minus 1 is 0. 8 minus 1 is 7. Infinity minus 1 is infinity. Dear student, tell me whether you understood up to this. Dear student, tell me whether you understood up to this. All of you acknowledge me. Whether you understood up to this. Dear student, tell me whether you understood up to this. Subtract the minimum value from the respective rows. Okay. Got it, all of you? Okay, fine. Now, what is the next step? Dear student, what is the next step? So, the next step is whatever the resulting matrix you got, whatever is the resulting matrix you got, now you have to find out the minimum value in the column. How many columns are there? Dear student, how many columns are there? And you have to find the minimum value from each column. Three columns are there. What is the minimum value in the first column? What is the minimum value in the second column? And what is the minimum value in the third column? What is the minimum value in the first column? It is 0. What is the minimum value in the second column? It is 2. Am I right? And what is the minimum value in the third column? Okay, like this way, we have to find out the minimum values in each column. So here minimum value is 0, here minimum value is 2. What is the minimum value in the third column? So the minimum value in the third column is 0. Fine. Now, dear student, you have to subtract this minimum values. Okay, whatever the minimum values we got with respect to column, those values we have to subtract from every column. Those values we have to subtract from every column. And after subtracting, you'll be getting resulting matrix. You'll be getting resulting matrix. So what is that resulting matrix, dear student? You'll be getting resulting matrix. So that resulting matrix here is infinity as it is, 0, 0 as it is. When I subtract 2, here I'll be getting 0. Here it is infinity. 7 minus 2 is 5. Here is 0, 1 and infinity. All of you got this? Up to this? Means first step is very easy, that you have to subtract. First step is very easy, that you have to subtract. You have to find first of all minimum value from the row. You have to subtract it. Then minimum value from the column. You have to subtract it. Okay. Make sure that it is visible. Okay. Infinity 0, 0, 0, infinity 1, 0, 5, infinity. Is that clear, all of you? Okay. Now, let us move ahead. Now, what we have to do? We have to find. All of you understood? All of you understood this? Yes, dear student. First, find the minimum value from each row. Subtract it, then whatever the resulting matrix you'll be getting, after subtracting whatever the resulting matrix you'll be getting, again you have to find the minimum in column, again you have to subtract, and after that you'll be getting this resulting matrix. You have to keep this in your mind, okay, because that will be required in later operations. That will be required in the later steps. So this is important. Fine. Now we have found the resulting matrix of first step. Now what we have to do? We have to find the lower bound. Now what is lower bound? Lower bound is nothing but the total reduction which we have done in this entire step. Total reduction or total reduced value which we have done, okay, in this entire step is nothing but the lower bound value for node 1. Is nothing but the lower bound value for node 1. So what is the total reduction? So I'll be writing here total reduction. Total reduction is equals to 2 plus 3 plus 1 plus 0 plus 2 plus 0. Means how much is the total reduction, dear student? What is the total reduction? This, this, this plus this, this, this. How much is the total reduction? Type in chat box. How much is the total reduction for this? How much is the total reduction for this? Yes, absolutely correct, Rishikesh. Total reduction is nothing but 8. So, dear student, 8 is the lower bound value of root node. 8 is the lower bound value of root node. Fine. 8 is the lower bound value of root node. So now I'll erase this. This is not required now. I'll erase this and I'll be writing the lower bound value of node 1. So how I'll be writing? I'll be writing here node 1. Okay. And its lower bound value, that means I have to write here in this case, the lower bound value of node 1, I'll be representing as LB, which is equals to 8. Okay. Lower bound value of node 1, which is equals to 8. Fine. Here it is. Now, we have calculated the lower bound value of node 1. Now, node 1, how we can divide node 1? Node 1 is nothing but the vertex 1, we can say. Now, dear student, tell me, vertex 1 is connected to, vertex 1 is connected to how many other vertex? 1 is connected to, as far as the diagram is concerned, as far as the graph is concerned, node 1 or vertex 1 is connected to how many other vertex? Vertex 1 is connected to vertex 2 and vertex 1 is connected to vertex 3. So accordingly, we can find here sub nodes, node 2, and here is node 3. Okay. Now we have to find out lower bound value with respect to node 2 and lower bound value with respect to node 3. This is what we have to find. Okay. So first of all, we will find out lower bound value with respect to node 2. Adati kashi find karnar lower bound value with respect to node 2. Tyasathi ha jo baghitla hota na last step cha jo pahila step madhe jo last matrix alela hota to consider karaycha aplyala. Okay. So let us take that matrix. Let us take that matrix. Last in the first step, whatever the resulting matrix we got, we will consider that. Kutla hota to matrix. It is infinity, 0, 0, 0, infinity, 1, 0, 5, and infinity. This. Fine. Actually, we are calculating. Ata apan kay find karto hai? Actually, we are calculating for lower bound value of node 2. So that means 1 is the root node, now 2 is the left child. So actually we have to find, we have to compute for path. We have to compute for path. Here path is 1, 2. 1, 2. We have to compute for path 1, 2. So to compute for path 1, 2, we are computing for path. This is 1, 2. Okay. As we are computing for path 1, 2, so here what we have to do, we have to set the distance of 2, 1 is equals to infinity. We have to set the distance of 2, 1 is equals to infinity. Why? You may ask one question, this important question to me. Ki sir, sir, apan path of 1, 2 sati calculate karto hai. तर आपण 2 टू 1 इन्फिनिटी का सेट करायचं? बिकॉज डियर स्टूडेंट, यू नो व्हेरी वेल, ट्रॅव्हलिंग सेल्स पर्सन प्रॉब्लम. ओके. इन ट्रॅव्हलिंग सेल्स पर्सन प्रॉब्लम, इच सिटी वी कॅन विजिट ओनली वन्स अँड वी आर कमिंग बॅक टू दी सोर्स सिटी. आता ह्या केस मध्ये काय करतो आपण, एकदा इफ आय हॅव ट्रॅव्हल्स द डिस्टन्स फ्रॉम लेट अस से कोपरगाव टू वैजापूर, ओके, इन दॅट केस अगेन वी आर to Kopargaon, we are not coming back. Okay, so here in this case various cities are connected, like Kopargaon, Vaizapur, Aurangabad, Yewla, these cities are connected. So once we start from Kopargaon, we reach to the Vaizapur. After reaching to the Vaizapur, we will move and we will search for the another city, maybe Yewla or maybe Aurangabad. Okay, so that is what the agenda. So in that case, if I am selecting path 1 to 2, in that case we will not consider for 2 to 1. So in that case, we will consider it as a infinity. So what we have to do? 2 to 1 means this is the entry for 2 to 1. I'll mark this as a infinity. I'll mark this as a infinity. 2 to 1 is infinity. इथपर्यंत समजलं सगळ्यांना? 2 to 1 इज इन्फिनिटी. ऑल ऑफ यू अंडरस्टूड अप टू दिस? यस डियर स्टुडंट, ऑल ऑफ यू अंडरस्टूड अप टू दिस? ऑल ऑफ यू अंडरस्टूड अप टू दिस? ओके ओके फाइन, लेट अस मूव अहेड. नाउ व्हाट वी हैव टू डू, as we are calculating for which path 1 to 2, as we are calculating for which path 1 to 2, so dear student, we will exclude first row and second column. We will exclude first row and second column while calculating the minimum row and minimum column, while calculating the minimum row values and minimum column values. बघा, ज्यावेळेस आपण पाथ 1 to 2 साठी फाइंड करतोय त्यावेळेस फर्स्ट रो अँड सेकंड कॉलम हा एक्सक्लूड करायचा आपल्याला. कशासाठी? ज्यावेळेस आपण फाइंड करतो की मिनिमम रो अँड मिनिमम कॉलम व्हॅल्यू. ओके, तसंच पार्ट 1 to 3 असेल तर वी विल एक्सक्लूड फर्स्ट रो अँड थर्ड कॉलम. जर आपण पाथ 1 to 3 साठी कॅल्क्युलेट करणार आहोत, इन दॅट पर्टिक्युलर केस वी विल एक्सक्लूड फर्स्ट रो अँड थर्ड कॉलम. Right now we are calculating for 1 to 2, so we are excluding first row and second column. Ata baga, as we are excluding from first row and second column, so what is the minimum value here? What is the minimum value here? Tell me, come on, hurry up. What is the minimum value here and what is the minimum value here? Yes, dear student, I want answers from your side. Okay, here minimum value is 1. Whereas here minimum value is 0. Correct, Janeshwari, Rishikesh, absolutely correct. Here minimum value is 1, whereas here minimum value is 0. What is the next step? Find zala aplala, minimum value find kela, barobar find kela tumi. What is the next step? Subtract it. Okay, good. So when I subtract it, I'll be getting this is as it is infinity, 0, 0. Here it is infinity, infinity, 0. Here it is 0, 5, infinity. As usual, this will be excluded. Okay, this is the resulting matrix. Good. Now what we have to do? What is the next step, dear student? We have subtracted. Fine. After that, what we have to do? Next step. What to do with this matrix? Yes, dear student, what to do with this matrix? What to do with this matrix? Yes, Payal? Okay, find out a minimum from column. Good. So here minimum is 0. Here minimum is 0. As we are excluding this, na? So this we will not consider. Minimum is 0. Minimum is 0. Subtract. Subtract those values. So when I subtract it, I will be getting again infinity, 0, 0, infinity, infinity, 0, 0, 5, infinity. Good. That's great. Okay. Same matrix got. Very good. So that again we have to remember. Okay. Later on. But kude te samala mahatvacha sangayche. की हा कुठे यूज होणार आहे. ओके, आता सगळ्यात इम्पॉर्टंट क्वेश्चन, नाऊ अ व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट क्वेश्चन नाऊ आय वॉन्ट टू आस्क इज दॅट व्हॉट इज द लोअर बाउंड व्हॅल्यू विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू नोड 2, बिकॉज दिस इज ओर. सो व्हॉट इज द लोअर बाउंड व्हॅल्यू विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू नोड 2? व्हॉट इज द लोअर बाउंड विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू नोड 2? सो डियर स्टुडंट, द फॉर्म्युला हियर to find the lower bound value with respect to node 2 is, okay, 1 1 1, your assumption as per whatever we have discussed, you are telling it is correct, but no, that is not the formula. That is applicable to only root node. Now we are calculating the lower bound value of node 2. So what is the lower bound value with respect to node 2? So dear student, lower bound value with respect to node 2 is equals to lower bound value of node 1 plus what is the value of A of 1, 2? What is the value of A of 1, 2? Okay. Plus reduction. Plus reduction. Now put the values into the formula. Put the values into the formula. I hope you got the formula. I know it is not clearly visible, but let me tell you. Lower bound value of node 1 plus A of 1, 2 plus reduction, current reduction. So what is it? What is it? Lower bound value of node 1. Lower bound value of node 1. Kai lower bound value of node 1. It is 8. 8 plus A of 1, 2. आता हे काढण्यासाठी ए ऑफ 1 2 काढण्यासाठी कुठला मॅट्रिक्स घ्यायचा? हा जो आपण वापरला ना इथे सगळ्यात पहिला मॅट्रिक्स तो घ्यायचा आहे. हा डियर स्टुडंट, व्हॉट एव्हर द फर्स्ट मॅट्रिक्स वी हॅव युज्ड दॅट वी हॅव टू कन्सिडर. सो ए ऑफ 1 2 किती इथे ही व्हॅल्यू काय जी आपण एक्सक्लूड केली होती? व्हॉट इज दॅट व्हॅल्यू? दॅट व्हॅल्यू इज 0. गुड. प्लस टोटल रिडक्शन. आता करंट रिडक्शन किती झालं आपलं? या स्टेप मध्ये रिडक्शन किती झालं तुम्ही आन्सर दिलं होतं बघा, पायलने, ऋषिकेशने, ज्ञानेश्वरीने उत्तर बरोबर दिलं होतं. करंट रिडक्शन इज 1. मग मला सांगा आता 8 प्लस 0 प्लस 1 मीन्स व्हॉट इज द लोअर बाउंड व्हॅल्यू ऑफ नोड 2? यस डियर स्टुडंट, व्हॉट इज द लोअर बाउंड व्हॅल्यू ऑफ नोड 2? गुड, व्हेरी गुड, इट इज 9. ओके, स्मार्ट आन्सर, इट इज 9. ओके, मूव अहेड. It is 9. I have written here 9. Okay. Move ahead. Now we have to consider. Ata aplyala kay consider karaycha ahe? We have to consider the path. We have to consider the path. Which path we have to consider? Now we have to consider the path 1, 3. This path 1, 3. Now, whenever we have to consider the path 1, 3, which matrix should I consider? Process karnyasathi kutla matrix gyu? Ithe baghitla apan 1, 2 for path 1, 2, which matrix we have considered? Sagat pahili ji step hoti, first step. First step cha jo resulting matrix ala hota, that we have considered for path 1, 2. Now, dear student, for 1, 3, which matrix shall I consider? Which matrix shall I consider? Mala kay manayche tumhala samajlo? Second step last matrix. Okay, Payal is saying second step last matrix. Ajun baki janche kay manne mala te pan baghu dya. What others are saying? Rishikesh, what is your opinion? Naneshwari, others, Audut, Altaf, Akshay, you also take active participation. Okay, yes Payal, you are on the way, you are on the correct path. Okay, first step of last matrix which we got from the first step. Why? Because we are calculating for 1 to 3. Root is what? 1. Here root is 1. So obviously we have to consider the, obviously we have to consider, yes, others keep on posting. Others keep on posting which we have used while path 1 to 2. Absolutely correct. Absolutely correct. Okay. So the matrix which we got in the first step, resulting matrix of first step, that we are going to use for 1, 2, 3. That we are going to use for 1, 2, 3. Okay. Absolutely correct. मग तो कुठला होता मॅट्रिक्स? हा होता का तो? इज दिस दिस मॅट्रिक्स? नो. ओके, दिस इज द सेकंड स्टेप रिझल्टिंग मॅट्रिक्स. सो विच मॅट्रिक्स वी हॅव टू कन्सिडर? वी हॅव टू कन्सिडर दिस मॅट्रिक्स फॉर पाथ 1, 2, 3. ओके, दॅट इज नथिंग बट इन्फिनिटी. ओके, 0, 0, 0, infinity, 1, 0, 5, infinity. Am I right? Dear student, am I right? This is what we have to consider. Am I right or not? Good. Now, as we are considering path 1, 2, 3, means which value should be infinity? We are considering path 1, 2, 3, means A of 3 to 1 should be equals to infinity. Yes or no, dear student? I am considering path 1, 2, 3, means A of 3 to 1 should be infinity. Barobar na? A of 3 to 1 should be infinity. Kude 3 to 1? This is third row and first column. Third row and first column should be infinity. Good. Now we have to exclude. We have to exclude first row and third column. We have to exclude first row and third column. We have to exclude first row and third column. When I exclude first row and third column, again I have to find out minimum here, minimum here. What is minimum, dear student, now? In this second row, what is minimum value? Yes, absolutely correct, Naneshwari. It is 0 and this is 5. So subtract. Subtract from the respective rows. When I subtract it from the respective rows, I'll be getting now here. What I'll be getting? I'll be getting 0, infinity, 1, infinity, 0, infinity. First row, third column. Am I right, dear student? Meanwhile, if you are facing any difficulty, any doubt, please feel free to ask your doubts or difficulties. Is that clear, dear student? 0, infinity, infinity, 0. Got it, dear student? Now, what is the next step? What is the next step? Find? Yes, keep on posting. Again, find minimum value from the column, first column and second column. What is the minimum here? First column 0, second column 0. So resulting matrix is infinity 0, 0, 0, infinity 1, infinity 0, infinity. This is the resulting matrix. Okay, fine. Now, dear student. Now, dear student, we have to find out the lower bound value with respect to node 3. What is the lower bound value of node 3? Can you guess the formula, or can you guess the value? Formula here is lower bound value of node 1, A of 1, 3 plus reduction. So, which is equals to 13. Yes, absolutely correct, Payal. 8 plus 0 plus 5, which is equals to 13. So, lower bound value with respect to node 3 is 13. Correct. Atha. Now, important thing is we are constructing here we are constructing here state space tree. We are constructing here state space tree. Now, dear student, we are constructing here state space tree. Now, in this state space tree, which node shall I expand now? That is important, because one is expanded to 2 and 3. Now we have to expand 2 or we have to expand 3. Which one? It depends on the value which we got as a lower bound value. So, dear student, we will expand only those nodes here in this case 2 and 3. We have to expand, we have to choose either we shall expand node 2 or we shall expand node 3. Here in this case, the value which is having minimum value. Yes, good, file. Minimum, okay. So here, the node which gives you minimum lower bound value, that we have to expand. It means we have to expand which node then? Here we will be having minimum lower bound, here lower bound value is 2, here lower bound value is 3, 13. So the one which gives the minimum value, that we have to expand. We have to expand node 2. Actually, dear student, hey, node 1, node 2, 3, hey, kai, these are the vertex. Baga, hey, vertex hai. Vertex 1, as far as your original graph is concerned, vertex 1 is connected to 2, 1 is connected to 3. So, that's point of view, ne, 1 is connected to 2, 1 is connected to 3 as well. Okay. Ada, we have to expand 2. 2 kasa expand karnar? Kyo, what is the value of next node? Okay, how to expand kela apan? Fine. What name should I give to this node? डायग्राम बघा तुमची ओरिजिनल डायग्राम त्याच्यावरन तुम्हाला आंसर द्यायचे व्हाट व्हॅल्यू व्हाट लेबल शुड आय गिव हियर नोड 2 दैट इज करेक्ट नोड 2 एक्सपांड करायचं आहे काय काय नाव द्यायचं या या नोडला नवीन नोड जो क्रिएट झालाय त्याचं नाव काय 4 4 इज द करेक्ट आंसर Yes, student, this is very, very important and interesting. So, node 4 is the correct answer? No. Then, see your diagram. See your diagram. Your diagram says that 1 is connected to 2, 1 is connected to 3, 2 is connected to 1. And 2 is connected to? What is the answer here? 3. Yes, absolutely correct. This is nothing but 3. Okay. Yes, Payal. Absolutely correct. 2 is connected to 3. Now we have to find out lower bound value with respect to node 3. So we have to consider the path 2, 3. Now, dear student, I want to ask a very, very important question. While considering path 2 to 3, which matrix should I consider for the processing? Which matrix should I consider for the processing? I hope you got my question. For calculating this path of 2, 3, which matrix should I consider? For the processing. Step 2 last matrix. Good. Very good. So path of 1, 2, whatever the matrix we got. Path of 1, 2, whatever the matrix we got, that we have to consider for this path of 2, 3. Because 3 is the child of 2. Ma 3 path of 2, 3 sati apan kutla matrix ghenar. It is a matrix that matrix we will consider. Okay. What is that matrix? That matrix. But for that particular purpose, we have to set A of 3 comma 2 is equals to infinity. A of 3 comma 2 is equals to infinity. A of 3 comma 2 is equals to infinity because we are calculating 2 to 3. Hence A of 3 comma 2 is equals to infinity. Okay, let me write the matrix here. That matrix is infinity, 0, 0, infinity, infinity, 0, three, two, we have to consider the infinity. Dear student, A of 3, 2 should be considered as the infinity. So, manje kay will? A of 3, 2 should be considered as a infinity. 0, 5, infinity. But here 3, 2. 3, 2 means this value will be converted to infinity. It is 5A. This is the resulting matrix of step number 2. This is the resulting matrix of step number 2, but here 3, 2 consists of 5, so that instead of 5, we want here infinity. Now, as we are calculating for path 2 to 3, means we have to exclude. Kai exclude karayche? We have to exclude something. Something manje kai? Which row and which column should be excluded? Yes, dear student, hurry up. We have to exclude second row and third column. Yes, second row and third column. Now find out minimum in first row and third row. 0 is the minimum, 0 is the minimum. Kai farak padnar hai ka aplya matrix la? Nahi. So it will be again infinity, 0, 0, infinity, infinity, 0, 0, infinity, infinity. Again in the column, subtract minimum value in the column, no change at all. So we'll be finding lower bound value of node 3 is equals to, what is the lower bound value of node 3? Yes, dear student, I want your suggestion. I want your answer here. What is the lower bound value with respect to this node? How can I calculate? I hope you got my question. Okay, fine. So here this will be calculated as lower bound value of node 2 plus A of 2, 3 plus total reduction. What is the lower bound value of node 2? Node 2 chi lower bound value kay hoti? Hi baga re. Node 2. Rishikesh? Right. Okay. You have made the correction. It is 9. 9 plus 0 plus 0. So what is the lower bound value at node 3? It is 9. Yes, dear student, pay the attention, last 2 minutes. Dear student, pay the attention, last 2 minutes. Now, observe carefully, node 1 is expanded into node 2 and node 3. As this gives you the less value, so we have expanded node 2. Node 2 will be expanded into node 3 because 2 is connected to 3. 2 is connected to 1. Can I write like this? 2 is connected to 1 here. Can I write like this? Asa lihu shakto ka mi? 2 is connected to 1, 2 is connected to 3. No, I cannot write like this. 2 is connected to 1 because already 2 connected to 1 I navarti. Okay. So again, I cannot write this. So only this is correct. Okay. Fine. So now what about this 3? What about this 3? What to do with this 3? Shall I further expand this 3? 3 further expand karu shakto ka? Karu shakto, kai problem nahi. Problem baga tumcha. Actual diagram baga. Kai 3 is connected to 1. And 3 is connected to 2. 3 is connected to 1. And 3 is connected to 2. ऑलरेडी थ्री इज कनेक्टेड टू टू आहे आणि वन पासन चाललेलो आहे थ्री पर्यंत, वन पासन चाललेलो आहे थ्री पर्यंत. सो अगेन इट इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड टू अगेन एक्सपांड नोड थ्री. येस, इच सिटी शुड बी प्रोसेस्ड वन्स. एक्झॅक्टली, दॅट इज वॉट द करेक्ट आन्सर. ऍब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट. ओके, सो नाऊ नाऊ हिअर वी कॅन से, हिअर वी कॅन से द मिनिमम पाथ इज, मिनिमम पाथ इज वन स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम रूट नोड वन. वन इज कनेक्टेड टू टू, टू इज कनेक्टेड टू थ्री, अँड अगेन थ्री इज कनेक्ट मीन्स अगेन वी हॅव टू विजिट द सोर्स सिटी. सो वन टू थ्री वन. हाऊ मच इज द डिस्टन्स? डिस्टन्स कसं फाईंड करायचं? मिनिमम टूरचं डिस्टन्स किती? व्हॉट इज द कॉस्ट ऑफ मिनिमम टूर? द कॉस्ट ऑफ मिनिमम टूर इज, डिअर स्टुडंट, दिस लोअर बाउंड ऍट नोड थ्री. किती व्हॅल्यू आली लोअर बाउंड ऍट नोड थ्री? व्हॉट इज द व्हॅल्यू लोअर बाउंड ऍट नोड थ्री? इट इज नाईन. द करेक्ट आन्सर इज नथिंग बट दी नाईन. मिनिमम पाथ इज नथिंग, मिनिमम कॉस्ट इज नथिंग बट दी नाईन. दॅट इज वन टू टू फोर, फोर प्लस टू टू थ्री फोर प्लस वन. दॅट इज फोर प्लस फोर प्लस वन, दॅट इज इक्वल्स टू नाईन. दुसरा कुठला पाथ आहे का? वन टू थ्री टू आहे, टू प्लस एट आहे, प्लस थ्री आहे, दॅट इज थर्टीन आहे. दॅट इज मोर. ओके, सो दिस इज वॉट द आन्सर अँड दिस इज वॉट द ट्री विच इज इम्पॉर्टंट एज फार एज द ट्रॅव्हलिंग सेल्स पर्सन प्रॉब्लम युझिंग ब्रांच अँड बाउंड इज कन्सर्न. गॉट इट ऑल ऑफ यू? सॉरी, युअर टाइम इज ऑल्सो ओवर, बट एनी हाऊ दिस पर्टिक्युलर प्रॉब्लम इज सपोज टू कम्प्लीट, दिस पर्टिक्युलर प्रॉब्लम इज सपोज टू फिनिश. सो दॅट्स वाय आय हॅव एक्सटेंडेड 10 मिनिट्स. गॉट इट ऑल ऑफ यू? हॅलो डिअर स्टुडंट, इज दॅट क्लिअर? एनी क्वेश्चन, एनी इशू? दिस इज व्हेरी व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट प्रॉब्लम एज फार दो आय अग्री इवन इन केस, सपोज इन केस युअर सेकंड सेम ऑल्सो एक्झामिनेशन, इफ युअर सेकंड सेम एक्झामिनेशन इफ पॉसिबल इट मे बी ऑन ऑनलाईन मोड, इट मे बी इन द ऑनलाईन मोड, स्टील द वेटेज ऑन दिस पर्टिक्युलर टॉपिक इज मोर. ओके, सो मोस्ट ऑफ द क्वेश्चन्स कॅन बी आस्क ऑन दिस पर्टिक्युलर टॉपिक ॲज वेल. ओके, सो ट्राय टू अंडरस्टँड दिस. सो आय विल स्टॉप हियर. थँक्यू ऑल ऑफ यू, थँक्यू व्हेरी मच. I'll end the meeting.